Hey, everybody, it's Lisa Kay, and I'm back for another Facebook Live. I know it's been a little while. We took a little bit of a break, but I am back, and I wanted to talk to you today about the four things you can do, the four energetic things you can do to stay healthy in autumn. And that's where we are today, because it is fall. Well, we're in October. It's actually harvest season, right? It's pumpkin season. It's Halloween. It's all that good stuff for what happens in the fall, at least here in the United States. And that's where I live. Let's see. And so I wanted to talk to you a little bit. You know, a lot of the people who are out there following me in my audience, I know you're interested in energy. I'm interested in energy. I love energy. I think energy, and we're talking about metaphysical energy today, is really a fun, cool thing because it is the thing that makes everything happen. And I just think it's one of the greatest studies. And, you know, the Chinese are very, they were the beginning. They were the first ones to really to document and study what we now call energy. And I'm just sharing this with a bunch of my groups out there. And actually, if you want to join my group, the Intuition Development Group, we're out there. And I need to, and you can get us there at, actually, if you go to my Facebook page, which I'm broadcasting this on now, you can actually go see the link to the group there. You just sign up. So, and we're gonna wait and see if we have people showing up. I know I'm doing this very early today. I should pick a time when, you know, we could do this all the time, on a regular basis. But most of the people watch on the recording. Okay. So in traditional Chinese medicine, so the traditional Chinese medicine started, oh, they say 5,000 years ago. And that's when they were trying to figure out how the universe works. They were trying to come up with their own scientific approach to how does the universe work? How does the world work? What is it all about? And their philosophy, which makes up not only their approach to life, but also their approach to health, their approach to medicine, traditional Chinese medicine, to everything, you know, everything from health to, hey, fighting, which is Kung Fu. And in the center of it all, in the core of all of what makes up Chinese traditional medicine, is energy, and it's energy healing. And in fact, acupuncture is a modality for doing this energy work, this Chinese medicine. So it's one, as you know, is one of the I guess you would call modes of Chinese medicine. And it's funny. I have an acupuncturist who, and it was, I don't know why I said this, it was so silly of me. And I said, you know, what do you think? Are you into, you know, into energy healing, energy medicine? And he said, that's what acupuncture is. It's all energy healing. And I thought I was like, of course it is. How could I ask that question? It was so silly. And what I love about him is he is not only is he an MD, a Western trained medical doctor, but he is also a Chinese medicine acupuncturist, a medical doctor. So that was kind of really, really kind of funny. So let's get back to how does this work? How does energy, what's the philosophy of it? Well, the way the universe works, according to the Chinese, is all about yin and yang. And it's the dark and the light, the hot and the cold, the highs and the lows, they're opposites, right? And as we go through the seasons, we are going through the changes of the phases, and we go through hot to cold, right? When we go from summer to winter, we go from hot summer to cold winter. And to get to winter, we're going through the fall, right? That's the transition. And I'm going to say hello to Sharon out there. Hi, from Alabama. Awesome. Love that. Love that. Okay. So, and if you're out there, I don't know if I can see the comments from the group, but I certainly can see them on my page. So come in, say hello, and post me a question if you have one. Okay. So seasons, summer to winter. And I think, you know, regardless of where you are, if you are in Alabama or someplace in closer to the equator than where we are in New York, you still have the phases. You're still going through it, unless you're on the equator. But even then, you know, I lived on the pretty close to the equator for over a year. And even there are seasons. It's a very, very stark contrast of rainy season or dry season, which is the hot season. It's always hot there, but so there are seasons there as well. And we're going through that phase, right? So we go through the phase of summer to through the transition to winter, which is cold. And then we're going to go back to summer again through spring. We are in this transformation, and that is what fall represents. It's transforming between hot to cold, summer to winter. And also, this is where we see, you know, this is traditionally the harvest season. So this is where we're collecting. All the plants are now going into dormancy. We're harvesting the fruits of what the plants have brought us. So even, you know, the like vegetables, you might be canning them and storing them for winter time, or gathering the fall fruit like pumpkins and gourds and apples and quinces. I just did a story on my quinces that I love, and they're kind of like an apple, but not right. They are a fruit. And speaking of that, you know, we store that food. We harvest it, we collect it all, and then we store it. And the story that I put on my Facebook stories, as well as actually my personal page, I'll move it over to my page, my Lisa Cage page, and then you could see how to poach quinces if you want to store them for a long time. So we're just like the animals, you know, like the squirrels that are gathering all the food for winter so that they can go and hibernate. Same thing with the trees, and, you know, up here, all the leaves are falling off the trees, plants are going dormant. So the basic law of yin and yang is really what Chinese philosophy and medicine is all about. And, you know, when you talk about what foods are good for you, how you should stay healthy, I think Chinese medicine is probably the best philosophy for what you can do to stay healthy, to maintain your health, as opposed to here in the West, where we wait till we're sick, we wait till something is wrong, something is bad, and then we go to the doctor, as opposed to what can we do other than, I guess, exercise and some other, you know, general year-round healthy things we can do to eat. That's what eat and do. That's what the Western world does. But in Chinese philosophy, the seasons are very important on what we eat when. And from Dr. Henry McCann, who's an acupuncturist, he said that the basic laws of yin and yang, one of the basic laws of them is that mutual transformation, or this conversion. And this law describes whether when either yin or yang reaches its zenith, its peak, it's spontaneously transformed to the opposite. So summer is yang, it's hot, it's has a lot of energy, right? And then now we're going into yin, which is winter. So now this law says we're going to transform into the other phase. So for example, in the dark hours around midnight, yin is at its greatest point during the night. And at that moment, yang is born, right? And then light starts to come back. Yang starts to take over and grow as the sun starts to rise. So during the course of the year, summer is the apex of yang. And after that, then the earth begins to transform and transition into the yin, into the cold, into the winter. And therefore, fall is that first season designated as yin. So we're going into it. We're in the first season of yin, right? There's only yin and yang. So yin is going to be fall and winter. And I'm going to say hi out there to Lucy. Hi, how are you? So again, in the study of Qigong and Chinese traditional medicine, the Chinese recommend you do some things to be in sync with the season to stay healthy. So remember, it's based on the yin and yang, based on the seasons. So I've got four of these for you, and I'll go over each one. So the first one is sleep. So in the autumn, it's where we're moving into a state of quiescence. Remember, quiet. So we should go to bed a little earlier. And that's the way we harmonize ourselves with this yin season that is coming as winter. Now, you can still get up a little early in the morning. And a lot of people who lived in the, quote, old world where we were farming would do just that. The old world of the people who were farmers would get up early and harvest the crops, even though it's getting darker earlier. So even though it's getting darker, we all hate that. Everybody says, oh, I hate it's getting dark out. but that's okay, you know, because we're going into the winter season and it's okay to go to bed a little bit earlier. And it's also a time of reflection, a time of quiescence, a time for us to have some time to maybe reflect. And I think we probably do that. I would say, I know for me, by the time we get to Christmas time, the end of the year, that is a time when we are fully reflecting back on the year. And so we're winding down to that. And we're celebrating, right? We celebrate the birth of the new, and listen to all those parallels, the birth of the new year. Once we go into yin and we go through the winter, now we're going to go into spring, which is now the yang season. We're going to go into rebirth, into renewal, into starting something new. And these are, you know, traditional philosophies. You know, it's not just the Chinese, but certainly the old philosophies of Europe, of Egypt, and how we go through these cycles. And we need to be in harmony with those because we're part of all of this. So that number one is to sleep, go to bed a little bit early, right? Allow yourself to be in harmony with the sun going down earlier. Number two, eat. What do we eat? Well, in the Chinese view, autumn is associated with dryness. It's drying out. You know, in the summertime, remember we were talking about how the rainy season and the hot season? Well, and the summer often is a lot more rain. And so for the Chinese, autumn is associated with drying. It's drying out. There's less rain. It's getting colder out. Our skin dries out. Our lungs are more vulnerable to colds and illnesses because our lungs dry out. So some of the foods the Chinese recommend during autumn are things that will help you stay, quote, moist. And these are rice, of course, if you're Chinese, you're always reading rice. Rice, sesame seeds, honey, walnuts, spinach, apples, pears, persimmons, and grapes. I didn't make these up. I actually got these from Dr. Henry McCann, so I'll give him credit for it. And who's the acupuncturist? Not my acupuncturist, but one who wrote about this. Now, for those of you who are not vegetarians, you can eat things like eggs, pork, clams, crab, oysters, and mussels. So those generate moisture. And the flavors that are good for the autumn time are things that are sour, which is actually my favorite. Not great for my acid reflux, but it's something I always like sour things. And the sour things that you might be eating are things that are high in vitamin C. And isn't that interesting how vitamin C is good for keeping away colds? So, you know, so we talked a little bit about, I think spinach is high in vitamin C. But yogurt is sour and it also, it has milk in it. So, you know, that is supposed to help keep you, moist. We'll talk about that in a minute. I have my yogurt here. I actually eat yogurt every day. And I was thinking, wow, that's great. So I'm good for autumn. Lemons, cheeses, and green apples are good examples. Now to drink, the Chinese say boiled water is good. So that, I guess that's warm water. So light teas, milk, soy milk, fruit juices. And we just talked about vitamin C. So fruit juices could be things that are high in vitamin C, would probably be cranberry juice, orange juice, and lemonade. And some teas that are good for autumn are chrysanthemum. And that's, so that is not the same as chamomile. Chrysanthemum is it's a flower, a big flower. And the Chinese do drink that quite often. I love chrysanthemum tea and mint. And you can also add in some goji berries. Goji berries have a lot of vitamin C. Now, there's one last thing. Number four is we're going to talk a little bit. Now, what I might not have mentioned is, well, I'm not an expert. I'm not a doctor. Okay. So I'm going to tell you all that now. I'm not a doctor. So I don't cure anything. I can't diagnose either. But I am actually a certified Qigong practitioner. Not an expert. But I do have a background in it. And one of the things you can do is there's an acupressure point for your lungs. And it's, and what you can do is if you are feeling like you're congested in your chest or you have a cold or you're coughing, have shortness of breath, one of the, and I think this is always cool, the acupressure points is, and I'll have to see if I could show you on this video. The line of the lung is, I'm trying to go back so you can see a little bit better. Okay. And this is my microphone, so I have to keep it with me. But the line of the lung comes down your arm like this, and it goes down the side of your arm that is where your thumb is. So that is the meridian for the lung line. And there is a pressure point. Let's see if I could show you on my arm. It's not too clear, but when you bend your arm, there is a muscle here that helps you bend that arm. And you can see on my arm, it sticks up a little bit. So probably a third of the way down your arm on the inside is a pressure point. And if you play around with that, if you move your hand around in there, if I could feel it right there, it feels a little sore. And when you press it, so that is that's the acupressure point for your lung. And, you know, if you're feeling like your lungs are a little congested, you can rub that a little bit and, you know, don't hurt yourself, but, you know, rub it. And it should help stimulate the flow of the energy through that meridian, through the energetic pathway, and help you breathe a little bit better. So I just thought that was cool. I threw that in because I think acupressure is pretty cool stuff. So those are the four things. Let me go over those again. And they are sleep, go to bed a little early, eat. And we can put a list out there of these for you. I'll see if I can get my podcast producer to do that. And drink. And then that little pressure point for your lungs. So that's kind of a fun, cool thing. So try these out. Be in energetic harmony with autumn. If you're in Australia, right, you're coming into summer now. Take notes and hold on to these for when you're in the fall season. So one of the things I can do is in the show notes, if you go to my website, lmk88.com, we'll put these. You know, I was just thinking maybe this would be a good podcast. So maybe we'll talk about this again and put it in a podcast. So try these out. Autumn is just another phase in rise and fall of high energy and low energy. And that's the way the universe goes. It flows and ebbs and ebbs and flows, right? And it increases and decreases. It goes from hot to cold, from high to low. So you need to be in the flow with the energy of the universe. So, and oh my gosh, now I'm getting Adele and Lisa out there. Hey, ladies, it's so nice to see you. Adele and Lisa are in my circle, in our membership circle, which actually is opening up in a couple of weeks. So one of the things that we do there is I go over not only how to practice working on your intuition. And but we talk about these things as well. Energy, we talk about meditation, we talk about things that support your intuition and how to use it and how to live a better life, how to work with all that good stuff, right? And so anyway, so oh yeah, I got a lot of hellos and hearts and things out there. So, you know, if you're interested, stay tuned here. You can also go to, I believe, if you're interested, in lmk88.com/intuition/circle and sign up for the wait list. And oh, Jennifer's there. Oh, she just signed up for the waitlist. Yes, go sign up for the circle waitlist, because we are opening it. I only open it up twice a year. And I just mentioned it because we have some circle members here. And we go really deep into all this stuff and how you can apply it and talk about how to connect to energy. And this is really just a fun way to, you know, help enhance your life, be in harmony with life, learn how to be happier, learn what we can do to support ourselves and be in a world where energy just flows and you are in the flow, you are in the zone, and just basically connected to source, connected to your inner guidance, get connected to your intuition and your gut feel so that you can make better decisions and move your life forward and know the right thing to do. That's basically it. So anyway, that's it for now. And if you're watching on the recording, I'd love to hear from you. So, you know, put something in the comments. I do read them. I do go back and I do look at those, and I'd love to hear from you. All right, everybody, that's it for today. It's good seeing you. We're going to try to do more of these Facebook Lives. I know you guys like it, and I'm going to try to be good and actually do a schedule. And then you guys will know when they're going to pop up rather than randomly pop up when I happen to have time. So I'll try to do that for you in the future. Okay. It's great to see you all. Talk to you soon. Bye.